Hey everyone, it's Robert Holland. In today's video, we're going to go over this studio session with Shannon. Just to be clear, some of the images in this video are edited, and if you want to see a comparison between the straight out of camera images and the edits, then you can find that linked in the description below, just so you know what happened in camera versus what happened in post-production. We started Shannon out with a clean beauty look. I'm not going to spend much time going over this one because I covered this setup in my tips for shooting on a pure white background video, which you can watch right up here. Great video, the best. But very briefly, it's a 600 Pro and a 28-inch beauty dish as key light overhead and an arc light underneath with silver for fill. This creates clamshell lighting, which is great for beauty work, but there is very little contrast here. We just wanted to light all of the skin up really bright.
When you're using any type of curved reflector, one thing you have to pay attention to is exactly how the light is bouncing off of it. On the left-hand side, you can see most of the light is bouncing right back into Shannon's shoulder and her face, making that really bright, but there's a lot of fallout as you look down the portrait and her arms get quite dark. Whereas on the right hand side, you can see that the light is more directed towards her arms, so her face isn't as bright and it's a much more even portrait overall.
And finally, there's two rear lights hitting the wall behind her, which is just my drop-in white background, and V-flats to reduce the bounce light coming back towards the lens. Then I lowered the arc light quite a bit to get some more contrast in the shadows for this look change. I also brought my gray background down and lowered the output on my two rear lights. Next, we put down some floor panels. These are 4x8 faux flooring panels that you can get from a hardware store. We stuck to the gray background and I switched the key light to a 60-inch glow Easy Lock Quick Octa, and I put a folding V-flat on the right side of the frame to bounce back some light into the dark side, and the white flooring bounced a lot of light back up into the picture too. In retrospect, there is a bit of unevenness in the background here. I wish I would have either double diffused the reflectors or backed everything up. That way the background lights had a little bit more space to even out. I've since added a strobe overhead in the studio to reduce the need for side background lighting. Next, Shannon did a makeup and outfit change to something with more color. I used two paper backgrounds here. The flame color is attached to our background holder, and then I put a yellow background in front of that, offset to show both colors. I turned off the left background light because the yellow background would have cast a shadow on the right background if it were left on. I stuck with the 60-inch Quick Octa as a key light and had the arc light back in for fill light. For the bare shoulder look, the Quick Octa was positioned camera left to define Shannon's features as she turned to the left side of the frame. But when she was wearing the blue zipper top, the softbox was closer to overhead, but still very slightly left, and this was to accentuate her cheekbones for closer portraits. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this behind the scenes look at my studio session with Shannon. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. If you want to see my future videos, make sure to subscribe and turn notifications on. Take it easy.